those sages, as soon as Rani Meena's dizziness got cleared and she got up, she started to talk in disrespect towards Narada and her daughter Parvati. She looked at Narada and said, "Isn't it you who went and said, our king, your daughter is going to marry Lord Shiva? You made her to serve him when he was in Yoganishta. You cheated us. We believed your words and we got cheated." Parvati completed the severe penance which even sages who do severe penance cannot do. "Did you make her achieve this for that severe penance? What will I do? Where will I go? It is like having lamp in hand and falling into well. What do you lose? Everything went waste only for us. Where did that Saptarishis go? They only came for Parvati's marriage talks. If I see them, I will pull out their mustaches and beards. That Arundhati who came with them also is very wicked. This happened so because of her words and my daughter's desire. Fixing this marriage for my daughter Parvati has become like leaving gold and taking the black beads. It is like keeping crow in the golden cage instead of swan. It is like drinking well water instead of Ganga water. It is like becoming happy seeing the firefly's light instead of sun's rays. It is like adoring to little fox instead of lion. It is like leaving rice and eating the husk. It is like applying the ash from the graveyard instead of the holy ash from Yagna. Leaving all devas to attain this strange looking Shiva only. My daughter did such a severe penance. Narada, I don't like you and your intellect and your rebellion nature. Our clan's discipline and excellence all went waste because of that Parvati. Instead of seeing all this with our eyes, it is better we die. How will I face my husband? Why should those Saptarishis come to my house? Everybody together spoiled my clan. If I had not given birth to any child, even that would have been better. Or even if I had died, that would be better." She was crying loud in distress, saying all this. At that time, Brahmadeva came there. When he came, Narada looked at Meena and said, "Meena, you didn't understand the natural form of Lord Shiva." For that, she replied in anger, "Oh, wicked man, you stay in distance. You need not tell me anything." At that time, Brahmadeva, who came there, said, "Meena, hear to my words. It is Shankara Bhagavan who creates, protects and destroys this universe. Without realizing his pure nature and beauty, you are worrying unnecessarily." For that, Meena said, "Swami, for what reason you all are spoiling my clan? It is better to kill Parvati than to give that beautiful daughter in marriage to that horrible poor man. You should not tell me to give her in marriage to that Shiva." By that time, Indradeva, along with Ashtadik Balakas, came to Meena and said, "Mother, he is excellent of all. He gets rid of everybody's misery. He blessed your daughter Parvati by giving her his darshan. Nobody else will get such a darshan." Meena could not bear hearing them. She said, "You also don't tell me those words. Instead of telling me this, you better kill me. I'll not give my beautiful daughter to such a clumsy Shiva." At that time, Saptarishis came to Meena and said, "What we said is not lies. It is not waste. Shiva Darshan will give special benefits. Lord Shiva has come to your house as the right person to marry your daughter. As he has come to your house, there is nothing else that will bless you with all auspicious things." Meena ignored what they said. "I will never give my daughter in marriage to that Shankara who has applied ashes throughout his body," said Meena. Her husband Parvatrajan came there. On hearing to Meena talk out of distress and anger, he said, "My love Meena, who all have come to our palace, why are you distressed at this time? Why is called Saptarishis? Lord Shiva protects the whole universe. He is filled with mercy and justice. He is capable enough to be prayed doing puja. I understood all this, so you don't feel sorrow. Marriage function should go on well." Rani Meena got more angry. She trembled, loaded with emotions. She looked at Parvatraja and said, "Hear to what I say and do as such. Tie a big rock on my daughter Parvati's neck and leave her in the sea." At that time, her daughter Parvati itself came there. She said, "Mother, why you think like that? How did you get this thought? Dharma was important for you. How did you give up Dharma? Sambhamurti is excellent and all. He is the reason behind Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra. He blesses all with comforts and good things in life. He is best in destroying the wicked and grazing the good people. Everything lies with him. He has no birth, no death, nor any bond with anybody. That is why devas have come along with him like servants. Didn't you see them? If you are doing good to me, tell me who is better than Lord Shiva. All efforts taken for this marriage should be useful. Shankara Bhagavan blesses all the worlds with all comforts. By giving me in marriage to him, you cleanse our clan and our home. Don't worry. If you are not marrying me to Lord Shiva, then I am not marrying anybody else. A small fox cannot attain a thing of a lion. By my mind, word and physique, I already attained him as my husband. Do you do as what you wish? Mena got more angry on hearing to Parvati's words. Oh girl, you have become a big person. You are talking against your mother. Wait, I will kill you or I'll kill myself. Thinking all sorts, she started blabbering. I inquired about that Shiva who came as a bridegroom for my daughter. Does he have a mother, a father, relations, agnates, brothers, sisters, a good character, tactfulness, a good house, a good dress, does dress up himself, good friends, a good vahana, youthful life, prosperity, good knowledge? What does he have? On seeing what in him, my daughter got a desire over him. How do I give my daughter to that incapable Shiva? What will I do? She was lamenting. At that time, Mahavishnu came there with a beautiful smile and looked at her and said, Mena, you are the Maya daughter for Pituras. You born Brahma's clan. You are fortunate. You are blessed. You are Himavan's wife. How do I say your fortune? You are a support for Dharma. Why do you lose Dharma? Will I, Brahma, and other devas and sages tell you something unnecessary? Will there be nothing auspicious in what we say? Can you also think it to be inauspicious? You really don't know your daughter's groom, Lord Shiva. He is beyond three gunas and filled with sattva guna. He only created Prakriti, the sole reason behind all these worlds. Virat Purush was created along with Prakriti. Then Brahma, me and Rudra, we three were created like a three guna Vasantarutu. Only after that Vedas, Devas, the plants and climbers we see and all the worlds were created. So who can understand the three-eyed Shiva's characters? He is Satya Swarupa and Jnana Swarupa. He is filled in all space and he is filled within all. He has no old age and death. He is head of all. He remains near to people who pray to him. Brahma, Rudra, Devas, sun, moon, planets, mountains, rivers, Kubera, me, all are that Lord Shiva's creation. As how from within a small seed, a big tree grows, spreading branches and leaves, from that ultimate supreme being only, this whole universe was created. At the beginning and at the end of this universe, the Srishti, only that Lord Shiva will be existing. Shiva's universe. Universe is Shiva. I am Shivam. You are Shivam. There is nothing else other than Shivam. It is ignorance to think there is something second to him. Lord Shiva, who created this universe, is filled in this universe. So only ignorant people will see universe and Shivam as two different ones. Wise people do not see such difference. The whole universe is Shiva.